In this session, we're going to talk about English language learners and second language acquisition. Throughout this presentation, we'll talk about the difference between BICS and CALPS. We'll look at seven myths surrounding second language acquisition. And finally, we'll discuss how to create an environment in your classroom that is conducive to second language acquisition. Take a look at this image. It shows an iceberg, and as you can tell from an iceberg, what you see above sea level is very small compared to what you don't see below sea level. There are two concepts that you need to be familiar with. The first is the concept of BICS, Basic Interpersonal Communication Skills. This refers to the surface level language, the here and now. This is the familiar content, the everyday content, the face-to-face conversations, the high-frequency vocabulary, which consists of approximately 2,000 words, the simple sentence structure, and the low-pressure language. Examples of BICS are, for example, a student asking the teacher, "Can I get a drink of water? Teacher, can I go to the bathroom?" or having conversations with their friends on the playground. BICS takes about 1 to 2 years to acquire. Acquiring BICS allows the learner to be effective in a social setting. But if we're talking about academics, now we need to look at CALP. CALP is talking about the cognitive academic language proficiency. It involves the experience and exposure to culture, lectures, formal, written tests, specialized terminology, humor, culture, idioms, textbook language, social appropriateness, nonverbal communications. It involves the information that's found in textbooks with limited interaction. The content is more abstract and less familiar. It's decontextualized. It involves low-frequency vocabulary and is often high stakes, having lots of pressure associated with it. In order to acquire CALP, it takes 5 or more years. Let's take a look at 7 different myths associated with second language learning. The first one is, children are better at learning languages than adults. The fact is, it may be true that children are better at acquiring the sounds of a second language. However, children's cognitive ability limits their ability to acquire the vocabulary and grammatical functions that an adult can. As humans mature, the brain also grows with knowledge and experience. This knowledge and experience give the adult learners the cognitive ability to analyze and apply language at a higher level than children. In other words, referring to the BICS and the CALP, it may be easier for children to acquire the social aspect of language. But when you're talking about the academic aspect of language, this is more effectively acquired by adults. Myth number 2. If a child does not learn a second language when he or she is very young, he or she will never be fluent. Fluency is often perceived as not only how much language a person learns, but how they produce that language. A child may be able to learn a language and not have an accent, while an adult learns the language at a deeper level, but still maintains an accent. Although the ideal language learning window is during the first years of life, which is the most rapid period of brain development, older children and adults can still become fluent in the second language. Myth number 3. Speaking 2 languages to a child may cause a speech or language disorder. The fact is, if a bilingual child has a speech or language problem, it will show up in both languages. However, these problems are not caused by learning 2 languages. Bilingualism should almost never be used as an explanation for speech or language disorders. Myth number 4. The more time English language learners spend soaking up English in the classroom, the more quickly they will learn the language. The fact is, language is not soaked up. The learner must understand the communication that's conveyed by the teachers. This is called comprehensible input. Briefly, comprehensible input means the information that the student takes in. This information has to be understandable and decodable to the student in some way. Myth number five, learning two languages will confuse your child. This is a myth that unfortunately many well-meaning teachers often convey to parents. The fact is, some bilingual children may mix grammar rules from time to time, or they might use words from both languages in the same sentence. This is a normal part of bilingual language development and does not mean that your child is confused. Usually by age 4, children can separate the languages but might still blend or mix both languages in the same sentence on occasion. They will ultimately learn to separate both languages correctly. Myth number 6. Bilingual children will have academic problems once they start school. The fact is, the school setting that best suits bilingual children depends on the age of the child. Immersion in an English language speaking classroom is the best approach for younger children, but is less effective for older students. For example, older students in high school would be better served to get instruction in the language that they know while learning English as a separate service. And finally, myth number 7. If a child is not equally fluent in both languages, he or she is not truly bilingual. The fact is that many people who are bilingual have a dominant language, which can change over time, depending on how often the language is used. In the United States, it's not uncommon for a child's dominant language to become English. School-aged children usually prefer to speak in the majority language instead of the one that's spoken by their parents. Here are 7 ways to create a rich language learning environment. Present rich language. This means don't be afraid to present second-tier or third-tier vocabulary to your students. Often, language learners are attracted to and remember words that sound interesting. Make them feel safe. Present vocabulary and daily language in multimodal ways. Use body language as well as verbal and written language. Provide opportunities for language use. Allow the use of the primary language. And finally, honor the primary language.